Dialogic version 0.6 is out and it brings some improvements in the character editor. Here on the screen you have the full list of changes that I will cover in this video. A new welcome screen has been added if there are no characters in your existing project, same as I do with the timelines. In this case it will give you an option to create a character and start editing it. You will notice that the UI has a few new elements and a few actions now happen behind the scenes. Previously, you needed to manually save the changes you made in your characters, but now they automatically save so you don't have to. I added this new option, which is different display name, and this changes the name that shows up on the dialogue. So if you have a protagonist speaking, you can show you on the dialogue, but the rest of the players when talking about them will display the assigned name. You can also use this for referencing characters internally, but not to the player. For instance, a question mark names and the real name in your character database. Portraits are finally here. Portraits or expressions are the graphical representation of your character while speaking. All characters will have a default portrait that will show up when they are on screen. But if you want to add variations and make it so they show different expressions, you can add as many as you want here. Whenever you add a new portrait, you can see the name and the path to the texture. I shared an early version of this on Twitter, but I made some UX improvements since then. You can see the preview of each portrait by clicking any of the related input fields. To specify which portrait to display in your game, I added this new option to the text events where you can pick one of the existing portraits, so it will pick this portrait whenever you are executing this text event. After version 1.0, I will probably go back to this and make it so you can pick a scene as a portrait. So if you want to have an animated or dynamic avatars, you can do so easily by creating separate scenes. For now, images will have to do. The default speaker options will make sure that any new text event that you create in a timeline, the character selected will be that one. So if you have a narrator, you can speed up things by selecting which of your characters is the default speaker. You can only have one per project, but you can change this at any time. So if you want to focus on another character, you can always alternate who the default speaker is. Behind the scenes, I'm trying to split the code into more manageable files because the main script was getting pretty long. I'll try to do the same with the rest of the parts and see how I can make the code as simple as possible. I still haven't tried making a huge project to optimize performance, but I'm keeping a close eye to it to make sure Dialogic is fast. So that's all for version 0.6. Now, if you look at the timeline, we can see that for version 0.7 I have the glossary and variables. This will be interesting to implement since it might be very challenging to build an easy and intuitive UI to handle custom variables. I imagine some events will also have to be edited, especially conditionals. And I also have to add new ones for editing current value of a variable. I don't want to overcomplicate it, so it will probably be a big dictionary and all values will be stored as strings. We'll see. Another exciting thing will be description variables, which show up on your dialogues when you are hovering that word so that you can explain some lore or remind players about some concepts that you might not want to be saying over and over again. I expect version 0.9 to be the hardest one, since I want to also do some changes in file structure before going to 1.0, but I don't want to get ahead of myself. Thank you all for your support. I've seen that you guys seem to be liking the direction of the plugin, and that makes me super happy. If you have any recommendation, idea, proposal, or question, please remember to leave a comment. I read all of them. So thanks again, and especially to my lovely Patreons. Bye.